So if we take a look here, it says calculate the standard entropy in kilojoules of a reaction at 25 degrees Celsius for the following reaction. So we have 1 mole of nitrogen gas combining with 3 moles of hydrogen gas to give us 2 moles of ammonia gas as product. And here I give you the standard molar entropies of N2, H2, and NH3 as these numbers respectively. Now, anytime your professor asks you to find the delta S of our system, they're really saying again, the delta S of our reaction. And that is just products, the summation of products, minus the summation of reactants. So products minus reactants. And remember, this also goes for delta G and delta H. Sometimes you'll be asked to calculate the standard enthalpy, delta H, or the standard Gibbs free energy, delta G. In those cases, delta G system, delta H system are products minus reactants. So here we're just gonna say it equals, we have, remember the coefficients, 2, 3, and 1. So we're gonna say, according to our balanced equation, we have 2 moles of NH3. Each NH3 is this total right here. That's our products minus our reactants. We have 1 mole N2. Each one is 191.5 joules over K times moles, plus the other reactant, which is 3 moles of H2, times 130.6 joules over K times moles. Now, we can see that the moles will cancel out. And our units here will be in joules over Kelvin. So when we multiply the 2 times the 192.3, that's going to give us 384.6 joules over Kelvin, minus everything inside of our reactants boxes. That comes out to 583.3 joules over Kelvin. Now just subtract those two. That gives me negative 198.7. joules over Kelvin. But remember, I asked for the answer in kilojoules, not in joules. So we have to do one more conversion. We want kilojoules, 1 kilojoule. 1 kilo is 10 to the 3 joules. And remember, 10 to the 3 is the same thing as 1,000. So joules cancel out. So our units at the end will be kilojoules over Kelvin. So it's going to be negative 0.1987 kilojoules over Kelvin. So that'll be our answer. So just remember, if they ask you to find the standard entropy of our reaction, it's just products minus reactants. Now, one more thing we need to realize here, just before we move on to the next set of videos, just remember, here we're gonna say that N2 and H2 are both in their natural states. Remember, your natural state means your by yourself, you're an element by yourself, example, carbon graphite or sodium solid. Or you're connected to copies of yourself, such as N2 or H2 or S8 or P4. So if you're by yourself, you're connected to copies of yourself, that's your natural state. Now, we're gonna say here, although N2 and H2 are both in their natural states, their delta S values are not equal to zero. Remember, delta S value is only equal to zero if the temperature is at absolute zero, 0 Kelvin. Now, we're gonna say that for an element in its natural state, delta H and delta G both equal zero. So if they gave us the values for N2 and H2 here, they both would be zero when we're looking up the delta H and their delta G values. Why? Because they're in their natural state. So I just want you guys to remember this. For something in its natural state, it means it's by itself or it's connected to copies of itself. In either case, delta G and delta H equals zero. Delta S can only equal zero for those compounds if we're at 0 Kelvin. Remember, that's the third law of thermodynamics. Just remember that difference, and you guys can answer those types of theory questions when you see them on exams.